Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I am Muhammad Yusuf. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, in the presence of the personal representative of His Majesty the King, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad Al Khalifa, the representative of His Majesty the King for Humanitarian Work and Youth Affairs, National Security Advisor, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received at Sakhir Palace a number of Muharrik citizens to congratulate His Majesty on the occasion of the holy month of Ramadan within the frameworks of His Majesty's keenness to hold meetings with citizens during the holy month. The citizens greeted His Majesty the King, wishing him many happy returns on the occasion and the kingdom progress and prosperity under His Majesty's wise leadership. They expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty for what the Muharrik Governorate is witnessing, thanks to his directors for many major services, development and housing projects and programs. His Majesty the King then welcomed the guests and exchanged congratulations with them on the occasion and expressed pride in the role of Muharrik citizens in laying the foundations of the comprehensive development in Bahrain and their contributions in the process of national action in solidarity with citizens, noting Muharrik's contributions to the ancient history of Bahrain. His Majesty affirmed that the month of Ramadan is an occasion in which the values of communication, solidarity, harmony and compassion that have distinguished the people of Bahrain throughout history are strengthened. He hailed the successes of the people of Bahrain in a number of fields and sectors, adding that they have proved their keenness to always serve their country with dedication. His Majesty also affirmed that the kingdom is moving forward in the development march in all its governorates to meet the aspirations and needs of its citizens. His Majesty the King wished them many happy returns and success in serving the kingdom and its development.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى الخليفة ملك البلاد المعظم حفظه الله ورعاه، أصحاب السمو، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها الحضور الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته، وكل عام وأنتم بخير. بمناسبة حلول شهر رمضان المبارك أعاده الله على مملكة البحرين وشعبها بالخير واليمن والبركات، في ظل قيادة جلالتكم الحكيمة سيدي أيدكم الله ورعاكم. خير ما نبدأ به تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا القارئ علي صلاح عمر.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة، أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله، وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة، هو الرحمن الرحيم. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر، سبحان الله عما يشركون. هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور، له الأسماء الحسنى، يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض، وهو العزيز الحكيم. صدق الله العظيم.
أما الآن مع كلمة أهالي محافظة المحرق يلقيها نيابة عنهم الدكتور خالد جاسم بمطيع.
After recitations of verses from the Holy Quran, Dr. Khalid Jasim Bumtayeh then delivered a speech on behalf of Muharraq citizens, in which he expressed honor to represent the people of Muharraq and congratulated His Majesty the King on the advent of the holy month of Ramadan. He wished His Majesty the King good health and happiness, and the country and its people further progress and prosperity. He praised the achievements and successes of Muharraq throughout history and hailed the prosperous era of His Majesty the King and all the accomplishments that overcame numerous challenges that were faced by the region. He praised His Majesty's keenness in promoting the values of tolerance and peaceful coexistence among different religions and faiths. He held the recent historic visit of His Holiness Pope Francis to Bahrain and participating in the Bahrain Dialogue Forum East and West for Peaceful Coexistence with the participation of the Grand Imam of Al-Azhar, Dr. Ahmed Al-Tayyib. He also expressed thanks and appreciation for the role of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al-Khalifa in leading Team Bahrain towards further creativity and innovation and investing in the youth of the kingdom. He also praised the role of Her Royal Highness, the wife of His Majesty the King and President of the Supreme Council for Women, Princess Sabiqa bint Ibrahim Al-Khalifa, in advancing Bahraini women on the regional and international levels in order to achieve sustainable development. He said that the people of Muharra congratulate His Majesty the King for the achievements that were made during His Majesty's prosperous era in all fields, especially in the sports field, most recent of which the achievement of His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al-Khalifa in the World Endurance Championship. He also praised the role of His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al-Khalifa in this regard. Dr. Bumtay then praised the advanced level of the BDF, the National Guard, and the Ministry of Interior, and recalled the fallen servicemen who sacrificed their lives to protect the homeland. In light of the development and economic achievements Bahrain is experiencing in implementation of the Economic Recovery Plan, he highlighted the major achievements that have been made, most notably the opening of the exhibition World Bahrain and the Kingdom's success in organizing the Formula One Gulf Air Bahrain Grand Prix 2023 and gaining global confidence in Bahrain's hosting the 146th Inter-Parliamentary Union Assembly, and Ahmed Al-Msallam being elected as the Speaker of the Representatives' Council and President of the IPU Assembly.
أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم. سيدي جلالة الملك المعظم، المحرق حضن وحصن، حضن ضم الأوائل من صناع تاريخ البحرين التليد، فانطلقت من المحرق إشعاعات النصر والعزة والعلم والأدب والثقافة، وهي حصن صد موجات المعتدين الآثمين على مدى التاريخ. المحرق جزيرة تغنى بها الشعراء وصيغت في تراثها الحكايات، وهي ملحمة بكل ما تعنيه الكلمة من معان. هي كتاب سطرت على مبانيه الأثرية، وفي أسواقه وطرقاته ومبانيه قصة بدايتها التاريخ وبلا نهاية. سيدي صاحب الجلالة، إن جهود جلالتكم في عهدكم الزاهر والتي تشكل مرحلة مفصلية من تاريخ مملكة البحرين التي عظمت فيها المنجزات ونجحت في تخطي العقبات والظروف كافة التي مرت بها المنطقة بكل حكمة واقتدار. نستذكر في هذا المقام اهتمام جلالتكم وحرصكم الدائم على نشر مبادئ التسامح والتعايش السلمي والحوار بين الأديان والمذاهب، والتي كانت إحدى ثمراتها الزيارة التاريخية لقداسة البابا فرانسيس بابا الفاتيكان لمملكة البحرين، تلبية لدعوة جلالتكم الكريمة والمشاركة في ملتقى البحرين للحوار الشرق والغرب من أجل التعايش الإنساني، بمشاركة فضيلة الإمام الأكبر الأستاذ الدكتور أحمد الطيب شيخ الأزهر الشريف رئيس مجلس حكماء المسلمين. والشكر موصول لصاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء لجهوده المثمرة في قيادة فريق البحرين لخلق بيئة محفزة للإبداع والابتكار والتميز والاستثمار في الشباب البحريني. كما نثمن الدور الكبير الذي ينهض به المجلس الأعلى للمرأة بقيادة صاحبة السمو الملكي الأميرة سبيكة بنت إبراهيم آل خليفة في تقدم المرأة البحرينية على المستويات كافة المحلية والإقليمية والعالمية لتحقيق أهداف التنمية المستدامة. إن أهالي المحرق يرفعون لمقام جلالتكم أسمى التهاني وأطيب تبريكات لما تحقق في عهدكم الزاهر من إنجازات متميزة على الأصعدة كافة، خاصة تلك الإنجازات الرياضية التي حققتها المملكة مؤخراً في بطولة العالم للقدرة بفوز سمو الشيخ ناصر بن حمد آل خليفة بالمركز الأول، مشيدين بدوره سمو الشيخ خالد بن حمد آل خليفة. إننا في هذا المقام نثمن وبكل اعتزاز ما وصلت إليه قوة دفاعنا الباسلة والحرس الوطني ووزارة الداخلية من مستويات قتالية وأمنية متطورة، حيث سجلت هذه المؤسسات التي نفخر بها جميعاً ملامح وملاحم وطنية محل تقدير واعتزاز من الجميع. نستذكر بهذه المناسبة شهداءنا الأبرار الذين سطروا أروع وأسمى التضحيات في سبيل الذود عن تراب هذا الوطن الغالي. سيدي جلالة الملك المعظم، في ظل الإنجازات التنموية والاقتصادية التي نعيشها في مملكة البحرين تنفيذاً لخطط التعافي الاقتصادي، لا بد من الإشارة إلى ما تحقق من إنجازات كبرى، أبرزها افتتاح مركز البحرين الدولي للمعارض والمؤتمرات، ونجاح المملكة في تنظيم سباق جائزة البحرين الكبرى لطيران الخليج الفورمولا 1 باكورة السباقات الموسم 2023، ونيل الثقة العالمية في استضافة البحرين لاجتماعات الاتحاد البرلماني الدولي 46 بعد 100، وفوز ابن مدينة الحد من محافظة المحرق معالي السيد أحمد بن سلمان المسلم رئيس مجلس النواب رئيساً لاجتماعات الجمعية العامة. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة المعظم، فيها هذه هي المحرق، وهؤلاء هم رجالاتها باقون على العهد الذي قطعوه على أنفسهم والذي تشربت به أرواحهم لمواصلة البذل والعطاء والتضحية والوفاء والإخلاص والولاء لقيادته الحكيمة والمساهمة في بناء الوطن وعزته وكرامته. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
The governor of Muharraq, Salman bin Isa bin Hindi, then presented His Majesty the King with a commemorative gift on the occasion. The governor expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King on behalf of himself and the people of Muharraq for receiving them. He stressed that the visit is an honor for all the people of Muharraq, affirming the keenness of His Majesty to meet with citizens on all occasions and the depth of the relationship between the leader and his people. He affirmed to continue on the path of development and prosperity which was achieved thanks to His Majesty's wise vision and the efforts of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, yesterday visited the Majlis of the BDF Commander-in-Chief, Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, then inaugurated the new Majlis of the Msallam family and visited the Majlis of the Minister of the Shura and Representatives Council's Affairs, Ghanem bin Fadl Al-Bainin. The Minister of the Royal Court, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, was at in the attendance at the Majlis of the BDF Commander-in-Chief. His Royal Highness highlighted the important role of patriotism and determination to Team Bahrain's ongoing efforts to further the Kingdom's comprehensive development led by His Majesty Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness exchanged Ramadan blessings with the hosts and guests of the majlises. His Royal Highness emphasized the important role that Ramadan majlises play in promoting the national values of tolerance and compassion and in maintaining the strong bonds that exist amongst the kingdom's citizens. His Royal Highness expressed pride in Team Bahrain's efforts in turning global challenges into ambitious goals and achievements. He emphasized the importance on building on the kingdom's achievements for the benefit of Bahraini citizens, adding that Bahrain's economic success ensures a bright today and tomorrow for current and future generations. His Royal Highness emphasized the kingdom's commitment to implementing economic development programs that guarantee quality opportunities for Bahraini citizens. In this regard, His Royal Highness expressed confidence in the next phase of the kingdom's economic development. The majlis hosts and guests expressed their gratitude to His Royal Highness for their visit and praised His Royal Highness's noble engagement with Bahrainis in their Ramadan majlises across the kingdom. His Royal Highness was accompanied by the Chairman of the Board of Trustees of the Isa bin Salman Educational Charitable Trust, His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, the Minister of Finance and National Economy, Sheikh Salman bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, and a number of senior officials. Thank you. The Representatives Council held its weekly session presided over by its speaker, Ahmed Al-Musallam. The council discussed proposals regarding compensation for employees working in ministries and agencies that are subject to the Civil Service Bureau for overtime, with cash compensation in exchange for rest hours. They also discussed the government's support for citizens with commercial records who were affected by the pandemic through Temkeen. The President of the Supreme Council for Health, Lieutenant General Dr. Sheikh Mohammed bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, in the presence of the Minister of Health, Dr. Jalila Hassan, visited Ali Health Center to take the booster dose of the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine. Sheikh Dr. Mohammed bin Abdullah affirmed the importance of vaccinations against seasonal flu, the coronavirus, its new variants, which will contribute to increasing immunity and prevention. He affirmed the awareness and keenness of the Bahraini community to get vaccinated, which contributed to Bahrain's achieving leadership in the field of vaccination coverage rates. He noted that the National Task Force for Combating the Coronavirus is keen on keeping pace with all global developments where all decisions are regularly reviewed. The Minister of Health asserted that Bahrain, in light of His Majesty's directives and visions, and with the follow-up of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister, has achieved top positions at the regional and global levels in vaccine coverage. The Shura and Representatives Councils hailed the government's approval during the cabinet meeting led by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister of the draft law of the state budget for the two fiscal years 2023-2024. The President of the Representatives Council Financial and Economic Committee, Representative Mohammed Al-Ahmed, affirmed that the committee's priority will be to raise citizens' standard of living, adding that the committee is keen on the fiscal balance plan and its approval at the end of 2024. The President of the Shura Council's Financial and Economic Committee, Khalid Al-Masqati, affirmed the Council's joint agreements with the Representatives Council's committee to achieve national interest. The cabinet stressed the importance of continuing to monitor prices and ensure the availability of commodities in the market to meet the needs of citizens during the holy month. More in this report. Clear interest shown by the government of the Kingdom of Bahrain in seeking to achieve food security and ensure the smooth flow of commodities in the markets of the kingdom. The last cabinet session, in which it followed up on the results achieved in terms of the availability of basic commodities through the measures that have been taken to enhance response to market needs in order to ensure the stability of commodity prices in light of the some global developments that affected energy supplies, availability, and prices of commodities in the same context. The cabinet stressed the importance of continuing to monitor prices and ensure the availability of commodities in the markets, especially during the holy month of Ramadan, noting the commendable efforts made by the concerned authorities and the commercial sector in this regard. The control and monitoring efforts continued throughout the past period by the Inspection Department of the Ministry of Industry and Commerce through visits that aim to enhance control and verify the abundance of food products to ensure the stability of their prices in the holy month.